So now we're going to go over creating a new assignment in Turnitin. So the first thing that you want to do is find the class that you want to create the assignment in and click on the title, the class name. And so now you can see that we're under the Assignments tab. And to add the assignment, you simply click on the big green button on the right side, Add Assignment. And you're going to give your assignment title something that obviously the students will recognize. So I'm just going to say History Assignment, point value, I'm going to say it's worth 10 points. This down here where it says only allow file types that Turnitin can check for originality, that just means Word documents, PDFs, things that it can check to see if any of that writing has been found anywhere else online. Turnitin now allows you to upload images, and obviously it's not going to be able to check for any kind of originality within an image, so that's why it gives you that choice. The start date is the date that students can begin submitting their assignments into Turnitin. The due date is the date that it's due, obviously. And then the post date is the date that the students can go in and they will see your comments or any grading that you may have done. Okay, and then we're going to click on this optional settings so we can see what else is available here. Any kind of special instructions. This allows submissions after the due date. So that's going to allow them to submit after the due date, but it will tell you, you know, that this paper was submitted late. If you don't want to allow them, then you just simply click no. And originality report, oops. So obviously, do you want to generate an originality report? Then that's your choice right here, yes or no. So maybe if you did have students that were uploading images, then you don't even need the originality report, so you would choose no. Okay, so this right here, exclude bibliographic materials from the similarity index. That just means that you want to not have the originality report include that material, and the reason being is that that material is most likely found online already as well. Anyway, so you might not want to have that in the originality report. So you can have the choice whether you want to exclude it or not. And then the same thing for quoted materials. And let's see. You can choose whether you want to allow students to see the originality reports. If you want to submit papers to the Penn State paper repository, which just means all of our papers go into one space, and then the originality reports can pull information from there to see if there's any similarity text found within the repository. Under the grade mark, if you want to attach a rubric or a form to the assignment, you can do that here, and you can actually launch the rubric or form manager right here. And then you can choose which rubric you want to use once you've created it. The ETS e-rater that they have now checks for grammar, so you can choose to use that or not. And then you can choose to save all of these settings for your future assignments if you like. So I'm going to click on submit, and now you can see that we have our first history paper assignment set up. You can actually edit it by clicking on More Actions, Edit Settings. You can submit a paper from a student yourself by clicking on More Actions and then Submit, or you can delete the assignment as well. So now what I'm going to show you is how there are other paper types that you can create. So once I've had this basic paper created, now I click on Add Assignment, and you'll see now it's going to say select your assignment type. And so this could be, say, your second paper that's due. It's just a basic regular paper. Then you would choose paper assignment. Peer mark assignment is going to allow students to review each other's papers, and the reviews are based on questions that you enter into the system. There's scale questions, so, you know, 1 through 5, what did you think of this? And then there's free response questions as well. So they go in, they're able to view their peers' paper, and then they answer those questions that you entered. And then the revision assignment just allows students to upload multiple drafts of a paper without overwriting the original one. And then reflection assignment is a reflection on their own paper. So those are the different assignment choices. That's about it for creating an assignment.